Oh, it's so good to see the city again. Oh, hello. You know, I used to come here all the time when I lived in New York. There was a charming little cafe nearby. I've heard this cafe owner is selling something called a Captain America cappuccino. I don't think it's likely that Steve somehow survived and became a barista, but I have to be sure. Unfortunately, getting inside the cafe won't be quite as simple as one might imagine. Nicely done. However, it would appear that Steve isn't inside after all, as if Captain America would be in need of a hot drink right now. In any case, thank you for... hang on, 10 cents for a cup of coffee? Can you believe it? Oh, it's such a good day. How could anything go wrong? You know, doing what you think is right doesn't mean you only ever fight the bad guys. I've got to get back to the Griffith without being spotted by any more SSR agents. I knew I should have brought my blonde wig with me. Wait, you look like a completely trustworthy person. Fancy a pleasant stroll through the city.
How much time do you think they spend working out?
Thank you.
Thanks for the hand. You're certainly more capable than that outfit you're wearing would seem to suggest. Sorry, that was rather mean. I'm having kind of a bad day. I should be able to make it the rest of the way, but thanks again. I wonder if someone will randomly ask me for a story about my past today. Disguise can often be an agent's greatest weapon. Working for the SSR, I often felt invisible to my co-workers, but on missions, the skill of not being seen usually proved to be very useful. Wait, who are you? Are you supposed to be my backup? You'll stand out like a sore thumb dressed like that. Help me follow this suspicious-looking character. Careful now. Keep up the good work, kid.
What's that? Speak up, Sonny!
Huh?
Hey! Huh? I hope you weren't trying to assault a police officer.
Well done, you. I dare say you'd make a fine agent. You know, sometimes the most dangerous work can essentially be summed up as a highly sophisticated game of peekaboo. I'll take these findings back to the SSR, but thanks again. The horror. The pasteurized, milky horror. Oh, hello again. You know, this Daisy Clover Milk Farm and I have a long history. You wouldn't think that a seemingly innocent-looking place like this could hold such a terrible secret. I previously infiltrated this organization by wearing a clever disguise. However, they won't be likely to fall for the same trick twice, so perhaps a rather more stealthy approach will be required. I'm not exactly sure what I expect we'll find, but I have reason to believe it might be something rather out of the ordinary.
I swear, nobody's taking that stuff away from you.
Thank you. Well, I certainly wouldn't have expected to find that. I suppose everything turned out all right in the end. I mean, yes, we did cause a small amount of property damage, but there's no use crying over spilled... What's that expression again? Such a busy city that never seems to change. Getting around a big city like this can be a little stressful at times, especially these days with giant green monsters rampaging down the streets in what is essentially their underwear. But it wasn't always like this, you know?
You probably get this a lot. You are awesome!
Where is that Mr. Jarvis? You'd think you could trust someone to show up to their own secret meeting. I can't wait any longer. I should get to the SSR. I mean, the phone company. Right away. Could I trouble you for a lift, please?
Stop in the name of... Ah, forget it.
Where is that Mr. Jarvis? You'd think you could trust someone to show up to their own secret meeting. I can't wait any longer. I should get to the SSR. I mean, the phone company. Right away. Could I trouble you for a lift, please? Thank you for your assistance. Your driving skills leave a lot to be desired, but you got me here, so that's a start. Anyway, mustache. I've got top secret, telephones to attend to. Cheerio! So beautiful. Well, the top side at least. When Howard Stark's inventions were stolen, Mr. Jarvis and I had to retrace the culprit's escape route through the sewers. It wasn't exactly pleasant, so you can imagine my reluctance to go back a second time. Jarvis! Now, where's he gone to? Honestly, of all the places to use the car keys... Wait. Perhaps there's a way I can retrieve them without having to go back into those wretched sewers. You there! Fancy a spot of fishing?
What?
They are. Wait until I tell that Mr. Jarvis. You'd think someone with access to Howard Stark's money would just buy another car. Oh well, thank you for your help. You've saved me a bath and several bars of diamond toilet soap. Well, I see they managed to rebuild the old place. I probably shouldn't say too much, but I came here once, years ago. I was investigating something for a friend of mine, and the trail led me here.
Looking for clues in this refinery shouldn't be too much of a problem. I mean, as long as there isn't a team of heavily
work. I'm free to search for clues now, so you'd better get out while you've got the chance. Oh, don't worry about me. It's hardly likely that things might spiral out of control and result in the destruction of the entire facility. Oh, why do I have to keep setting myself up like that? Angie,
You were always meant for great things. My friend Angie was finding life as an aspiring actress rather difficult, so when she told me she was auditioning for a role in a small play, I felt I should be there for her. Glad I managed to avoid having to take lunch orders for once. Now I can use my break to go and meet Angie at... Wait, is that the time? Already? You wouldn't be able to give me a lift by any chance, would you?
The captain got told off by me. Don't make me write you a ticket. I hope you weren't trying to assault a police officer.
Hey, this suit costs more.
Glad I managed to avoid having to take lunch orders for once. Now I can use my break to go and meet Angie at... Wait, is that the time? Already? You wouldn't be able to give me a lift by any chance, would you?
This should be far enough. If Angie sees me being driven by someone dressed in your attire, she'll ask a lot of questions. Actually, perhaps you and I belong on stage. What with you in that outfit and my ventriloquism act? Actually, forget I said that.
I never enjoyed those old Captain America radio shows. I mean, really, who writes such rubbish? But when I hear them now, they seem to make me feel strangely nostalgic. There is, however, one particular character I'm not such a great fan of. Nurse Betty Carver, can you believe that? They've changed my name and put me in their silly little radio show. It's completely disrespectful to the actual Captain America. Someone really ought to be doing something about this.
Thank you.
I can't do it. I really don't like the program, but I suppose if it cheers other people up and they enjoy it, then who am I to judge? I just hope that someday the real story of Captain Steve Rogers can be told, preferably without a damsel in distress. Ready for another adventure? All right. But you must focus. Please, focus. Oh, sorry. I forgot. I'm not a big fan of that particular phrase for some reason.
Why are all these people fighting each other? Best guess, Dr. Fenhoff and Dottie Underwood discarded some midnight oil in this area. We need to find a way to calm everyone down before it's too late. Hurry!
The captain got pulled off by Steve's captain, and we're jealous enemies.
It would appear that dancing isn't this group's greatest skill. Thank you for all your help, and always remember to know your value. Anyone else's opinion doesn't really matter. Take care.